And in many African countries, these outfits are formed on the basis of ethnic affiliation. Your typical African political party is simply an assembly of ethnicities. And in many African nations, you will discover that what we call elections is simply an ethnic census to determine which ethnic group is larger than the other. It is Julius Nyerere of Tanzania who said it. He said that the tragedy of Africa is not what the song is, not the song that is being sung, but who the singer is. And what he meant was very clear, that you may have an agenda that is good for your nation, but if you do not come from a particular ethnic group, those who will follow you will not be from your ethnic group. You may sing the best song, but when you look back, you'll discover that it's only people from your ethnic group who are following you. And when you have such a situation, the design is inherently conflictual. And that is why, therefore, when you look at Africa today, you discover that after every election cycle in many African countries, there is conflict. Because you go into the election, or the political parties go into an electoral process on the basis that we must win, and if we don't win, the elections have been rigged. In other words, we place so much premium on the presidency, and you'll see in many African countries, entry into government is like winning a lottery. It is winning a lottery because it gives you access to resources. And therefore, people say, people claim the president. If you are in a country, say, and one of your own means a son, they are normally sons. One of your own sons has won the presidency. The tribe celebrates from the herdsman to the professor, from the fisherman to the intellectual, because we have now won the presidency. We have won the lottery. We will have ministers. We'll have all these, and everybody else feels excluded, and that generates conflict. And we have seen it, whether if we don't see it in Gabon, we see it in Guinea-Bissau. If we don't see it in Guinea-Bissau, we see it in Kenya. If we don't see it in Kenya, we see it in South Sudan. So that in South Sudan, if one were to ask them, what is the problem? The contest is of an ethnic kind. They are contesting because one of our own must occupy the state house. And that is why, therefore, you see, under the guise of democracy in a number of African countries, we create offices which are sinecures. You will have a president, you'll have a deputy president, you'll have a second deputy president, you'll have a prime minister, first prime minister, first second prime, all those useless offices which make no sense, because you have to appoint people into those offices and give them a motorcade so that when they go to their villages, they look important and the people own them as ours.